Hi everyone, this is Sukant Chandan here from Sons of Malcolm on Tuesday the 30th of August 2011, and I'm going to be speaking specifically about Libya, particularly so because there's a complete media blackout on actually what's going on the ground. The whole Western media and much of the Arab mainstream media is completely complicit and collaborating in this NATO war on Libya from the beginning. It's 1 week on now from this assault on Tripoli. The Daily Telegraph has admitted that this assault that happened, started just over a week ago on Tripoli, was organized and planned by the British Armed Forces and other forces of NATO. So this is no civilian uprising. This is not in control of any faction in Libya. This is all under the edict and the control of NATO. And indeed, this whole Libya operation for the last 6 months has been a NATO conspiracy. It's been very clear from the time that British Foreign Minister William Hague said Gaddafi had fled to Venezuela on the first day of the protest, also on the first day that Fidel Castro said NATO is coming for Libya, but also the SAS were on the ground on the first days around Benghazi over 6 months ago, and a conversation between the former British ambassador to Libya and the head of the National Transition Council, so-called, in Benghazi, Mr. Jalil. A conversation about the SAS landing was picked up by Libyan state media at the time and broadcasted. So this is without a doubt, and everyone should have this very clear in their mind, this, that the roots and the mastermind of everything that's happened in Libya in this crisis the last 6 months is based in London, Paris and Washington and Rome, not amongst Libyans. Libyans have no real control over what is happening to their country. And if you're in doubt, go look at the square, the main square in Benghazi. You have a banner there, which the title is The Fantastic Four. Who are the Fantastic Four, which the rebels are giving so much love to? It's Susan Rice, it's Obama, it's Sarkozy, and it's our very own British Prime Minister, Cameron. These are the leaders of the so-called Libyan revolution against Gaddafi. And again, if you're in any doubt, look at the French flags, the American flags, the British flags flying, being flown by the rebels, and the rebels literally embracing and kissing it. So make no doubt in your mind, this is a Western conspiracy against Libya, very clearly.
People tell me that I should distance myself from my brother. See, I'm not that kind of punctified Negro.